Hello, 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 it is William's Chess Channel here, coming at you with another chess video. Here, I want to analyse some of the comments made by this Greek Grandmaster who is doing the commentary for the European Club Cup. I've learnt a lot from listening to him talk. His name is Papaioannou. But firstly, just a quick recap of round one. It saw the top four boards winning with a professional 6-0. Here are a few of the lessons I've learned from Papaioannou so far from his excellent commentary. I hope you will enjoy the video. Round 1 lessons. Number 1, the Benko Gambit trap.
I'm sure you know him. He used to be a very strong player and a very good chess trainer. Many, many years ago, long before the computer era, he showed me a line that almost refuted the Benko immediately, but almost. Let's have a look. After B takes A6,
yes,
he showed me the move, just a second, G6. This was supposed to be at that time more accurate.
Yes.
Yes, and after G6, white plays E4, surprisingly. E4. This move almost refutes the Benko. White is threatening E5 already. And black takes it, and now here comes queen a4, threatening the knight, knight f6, for example, and a7. And the next move is going to be a takes b8. I lose my queen on a4, but I promote a queen and I take one knight. But white is very unlucky because he's much worse after knight a6, very strong move, bishop takes a6, rook takes a7, and all of white's tries are in vain now.
Yes.
Because he. White is much worse, finally.
This is interesting. I've never
but
seen
it was
this
close.
Before.
Yes, it was close. Yes. This was shown to me maybe 20 years ago.
Wow.
Yes.
Okay, so bishop takes a6.
Looking at the chess-based database, 11 players have tried this e4 Benko opening trap. It does not work out most of the time. There have been many black wins. Number 2, your chess openings reflect your personality.
Did you ever play the Queen's Gambit?
When I was very young, yes, I did. When I was very young, but it is a little bit too passive for my taste. I need to play a little bit more active. Of course, I understand it's the tremendous value. Every world champion would also include the Queen's Gambit in his repertory, but. No, I never had a trainer in my life, so there was nobody there to teach me to why this opening is good and how to play this opening. Hmm.
You think that openings are also a matter of taste?
They are also a matter
in
of...
In a sense, I mean, okay, there are several openings which are good.
Mm-hmm. Yes, play. It's a matter of taste, and it, I would say it reflects someone's personality, you know, you can see what kind of person he is through his opening choices. Yes, but of course there are a few players which play every opening. In that case, you cannot see what kind of person he is. Yes.
Number 3. Now we get Papaioannou's views on the match in London between Fabiano and Magnus.
What do you think about the upcoming match between Carlsen and Caruana? You said that. And I agreed that we shouldn't ask him.
Yes, let's better not
but
ask him. Yes.
Now that he's not here.
I will tell you what I think. If I have to choose one player, I believe Magnus Carlsen will win. But of course, it's not sure at all. But if you have to pick one,
yes
Caruana of course has very good chances. And this
even 51%, 49%.
Yes, exactly. Before you talk, you have 50% chances.
Yes.
But you need to pick one. I would choose Carlsen. Now I will tell you who I want to win.
Yes.
I want the winner to be the player who will play the best chess. Which one is going to be? I don't know. The player who will play the best chess.
Which is not certain. Maybe he.
It's not certain. The player who will play the best chess in this championship. Who is it going to be? We don't know.
You probably think that it will be more interesting than his previous matches against.
Yes,
Kariakine
more interesting. Yes, because Caruana is young and younger than other competitors, and also because I have the feeling that Caruana is not afraid of Carlsen. The others were afraid, clearly afraid of Carlsen, mm-hmm. but Caruana is not. He has lost many times, of course, against Carlsen, but he has won also
yes.
quite sometimes.
I think yes? Carlsen mentioned this in a recent interview on chessbase.com. Mm-hmm. He was giving an interview and he mentioned this fact that he also believes that this match will be his toughest test mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. because Caruana has beaten him many times.
Yes.
Number 4, a reverse London Torre attack.
Entered some Ninjo Indian area or Queen's Indian. White has a very useful tempo up, and practically this is very, very bad for Black because.
In the practical sense.
Yes, of course, and in theoretical, because we agree to play with Black to make White our opponent's favor. Now White is very happy and he's thinking during the game, let me see now. He's sitting, you know, like a king, very happy, and he's thinking how to use my extra tempo. Let's compare the variations. But on the other hand, Black is thinking, can I do this now, which I know in theory, or the tempo less will lead to my defeat? Can I do this? So it's like both players are agreeing that White will be better. Why did this happen? Because Black wanted with a tempo less to make direct contact in the center with d5 and c5. A better strategy would be to play openings, a reversed opening that doesn't have direct contact. Such openings are two, the London system and the Torre system. So it is no coincidence that Ding Liren chose a reversed London system. So knight f3, knight f6, let's go back from the beginning, knight f3, knight f6, b3, d5, bishop b2, bishop f5, e3 and e6. You see, Black doesn't want to occupy the center with too many pawns, c5 and everything, because this will give additional targets to White. So this is actually a reversed London system, which is a very quiet system, and tempos are not important because there is no direct contact in the center. So tempos are not very important, and in this way Black says, now I am becoming White, after a few moves I will have the white pieces and maybe a very small advantage. That's the way we should think. Also, instead of bishop f5, a nice possibility would have been to play bishop to g4, and this is a reversed Torre system. The problem with this is that white will play e3, no, e3 is better, and after e6, for example, there are some dangerous ideas with h3 and g4 at some moment, and take this bishop from g6.
Uh-huh, so
yes,
for example,
these ideas, yes, and maybe knight h4 or knight e5 or something. This can be very dangerous.
Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video format, leave a comment below. Click the Williams Chess Channel icon to subscribe to this channel. Plus, check out all the other videos I know you will love too. Until next time.